Elder Blacklight here. Now, do you notice the title of what I'm about to show you is called "It's Too Late"? Is it too late? Is it too late? Now, you got a whole lot of different type of leaders. This is from Tannenbaum's Black Journal around 1972. You don't see the Honorable Elijah Muhammad's in that group. You don't see the Honorable Elijah Muhammad in that group. But he's there by phone. And this right here that I'm about to share with you, you can see this video in its entirety on YouTube. Is it too late? On Tony Brown's Black Journal. And I'm going to use this video to show you how the government and the Caucasian establishment is playing us against each other, and how you got many Judases in this crowd right here. These groups exist today. The Urban League. But we're going to open up before I get too deep in it with Tony Brown talking. Then I'm going to, you know, pause it and interject some of my thoughts in there. This might be a lifesaver right here, what I'm about to share with you.
Can black people survive culturally and physically in America? Can we ever be a part of the existing white institutions, or should we be developing our own? Can we as a people develop solutions to our dilemma fast enough to counteract the present rate of growth of the oppressive factors built into this society by institutional white racism? As black people, we must deal with the issue. Is it too late? Tonight on Black Journal, Reverend Ralph Abernathy, Imamu Amidi Baraka, Dr. James Chief, Reverend Albert Clay, Congressman Charles Diggs, Jr., Mr. Dick Gregory, Miss Dorothy Height, Mr. Roy Ennis, Mr. Vernon Jordan, Dr. John Morcell. What is the present condition?
They didn't even mention the Honorable Elijah Muhammad's name. They showed his picture, though. We're going to cut it right here because I got those gentlemen, some of them are deceased, most of them are deceased. But they all got their points of view. Now this, if you look around today, September 11th, 2020, we in a pandemic here in America and really all over the planet. And We're going to try to go through this entire presentation. Is it too late? This question is relevant today. Most of these organizations still exist, but they're not the same. And some of them yet is the same. But my point is that the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, or the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, he painted a picture along with his talk. And the picture he painted, even after he died, shows us how to separate from the Caucasians and do for self. And it also shows us how we can tell the hypocrites and the Judases. And when you hear the elders of Zion talking about the protocols of the learned elders of Zion, and they mention the Goans, and they say they are animalistic, that means that their minds are like animals. In other words, eat, sleep, and freak is the only thing that animals mainly do. They don't build nothing. They don't experiment. They don't explore. They have reduced the black man down to that going type mentality, because we're being led around by the nose like a pit bull leads a cow by the nose, or a bull by the nose. A bull is a strong, powerful beast, but that pit bull was bred for shepherding or corralling that bull. They put a ring in the bull's nose, and that pit bull got the grip, pressure in his jaws to latch on to that sensitive ring in the bull's nose, and lead the bull into the corral. The black man is strong and bullish, but the white man got that ring in his nose. And being the dog that he is, he could latch on to that ring in that black man's nose and lead him anywhere he want to go. And we're going to prove this by using this presentation, Is It Too Late, as an example. Sugar and sugar, salt and salt. I got the kind of flavor that will save you. The kind of knowledge you won't get in college. And if you don't take it in, it ain't my fault. War.